And welcome back. On this section of our show, we are welcoming Officer Allie Eggers from the Fairfax County Police Department, and you are our crime prevention officer.
Yes, I am.
Welcome back to Village in Motion.
Thank you very much.
And what are we going to talk about today?
I think we should talk about summer safety tips.
I think that's a good idea. What's the most important one?
There's so many, and I think they're all equally important. I think the one thing to remember that this time of year is that we're starting to get this telephone scams. They're, depending on the time of year, they ebb and flow about what it's about. But basically, you know, this is the time of year where kids are graduating, they're getting the phone calls that, oh, by the way, you know, I'm on a beach vacation in Mexico, I've been locked up in jail, please send money, you know, and it turns out that their grandson, granddaughter was never in Mexico or something along those lines.
And what should one do if one gets a call like that?
Typically, what I tell people is if there's a high emotion when you get this type of phone call, then that's kind of a red flag for you, because the name of the game kind of stays the same, but they change some of the wording and how it's laid out. But typically when you start to get that high emotion, whether it be guilt because it's a charity organization, quote unquote, or anxiety about, you know, oh no, my grandson or my granddaughter's in a Mexican jail somewhere. Or as we know, and we've already previously discussed, is that one of the directors here got a phone call this morning, and I'll be happy to read it.
Yes, this is a good one.
Yes, it is. So a voicemail message was left. It says, you're custody by the local police department as there are four serious allegations pressed on your name at this moment. We would request that you get back to us so that we can discuss about this case before any legal action against you. The number to reach is, and they give the number and then they repeat it again. That's an example of that high emotion of, oh no, what's happened? You know, is there some kind of warrant out for me? It's the same if you get the phone call from the IRS, you know, those types of things. So again, that's that high anxiety, something's wrong.
So what would happen if she called this number?
More than likely, they would try to obtain her full information. They would probably ask her to pay by phone, whatever this warrant is, if you pay a fine and there's a fee associated with it because it's gone over 30 days or 60 days. So there would be a whole scam to try to get that information via
the
phone.
What should she do?
First of all, what I would say is, obviously, I'm here and I know nothing about this particular person being wanted. I would say the bottom line is, if, and this was an out of area phone call, so if you are not from that area, you've never been in that area,
and
anything like that.
The phone numbers here are 800 numbers, right?
No, this is not an 800 number. It's not an 800 number. Also realize that they can make the number say anything.
Oh, that's true.
And they can also have your caller ID have it say whatever number it is, and it will say they have a computer.
So you can't count on the number telling
you anything.
Correct.
The number, and a lot of times, even with these scam calls like from your bank, it'll say SunTrust Bank, but it's not your bank. So
right.
What I advise is that, you know, you can call your local police department, you can ask, you know, if there's anything that they know about. I can pretty much guarantee you almost 99.9% of the time that it's a scam. You know, they're not gonna ask for your personal information by phone, and they would also send a letter also to your home if there's some type of warrant on file or if there's fines that you need to pay, things like that.
Probably the best advice, the first thing to do is just sit down, take a deep breath,
correct,
and think about it.
Correct.
And say, okay, you know, and no matter how excited someone is on the phone, sit, think about it, say, okay, now is this for real?
Correct.
And just don't panic about it. Don't get upset. If it's the grandson in jail, get a number, call them. They say, okay, I'll call you back. Let
correct
me check on this.
Correct.
Just don't get excited about it. If it's a mail scam or a phone scam, one thing you can do here, and our philanthropy director was talking about this just the other day. We had a postal inspector here to speak. You know, go to our philanthropy department and show them.
Correct.
They're used to seeing this.
Correct.
And say, does this look like it's for real?
Correct. And like I said, that's that high emotion.
Yes.
And I always tell people, you know, make that phone call to that relative, you
right
know, the parent of said grandson, grandchild, yes, and say, you know, hey, did you know about this, whatever it may be, you know, and allow them to be the parent and to figure out what's going on.
Yes.
And like I said, 99.9% of the time, and probably even closer to 100,
right,
is that it's a scam. And yes, again, it's the same thing with those phone calls from the IRS, you know, like I said. And
the IRS never contacts people by phone, correct?
They will not contact you by phone. And then the IRS, if you owe them money, make sure that they'll get their money.
Yes, right.
So you don't have to worry about
that.
Correct. And you also have to remember, when you're talking about, you know, there's warrants on file, you know, things like that, you should be getting a letter. Like even in Maryland, where they have the photo red light and the photo speeding, they send you letters,
yes,
multiple letters,
yes,
in the mail. And you can verify the phone number via online, things like that. So you can verify all that information prior to paying some type of fine.
Yes.
And again, it's that high pressure, high anxiety that you start to feel.
Don't let somebody push you.
Correct. And again, once you feel that, you need to know, okay, this is a warning sign that something may not be right.
A couple of hours of you doing some checking about it is not going to make a difference.
Correct.
Yes.
Correct.
Right. Very good advice.
And like I said, this time of year, what I advise people is also, with it being lighter, till almost 9 o'clock.
Yes.
You know, people want to go out and about. They're going to the movies, they're going out to dinner, whatever it may be. If you know that you're going out to the movies or going to a dinner, and you know that you're going to be there after dark, park in a well-lit area.
Oh, good idea.
So that you're prepped in advance. If you don't want to take your purse with you, that's fine. You know, you can put it in the trunk, lock the car. You know, in theory, most of crime that occurs are crimes of opportunity. So understand that someone can walk by a car, they see some items in it, whether it be an iPad, a cell phone, loose change, sunglasses, an easy pass even, that they'll pull the door handle, and if it opens, they go in. If it's
not... Let me make a suggestion.
Sure.
The place to put your... To go... The time... Let me rephrase that. The time that you want to put your purse in the trunk is not in the parking lot of the theater.
Correct.
Do that before you leave home.
Correct.
So that the person who's looking in cars doesn't see, oh, well, there's Mrs. Jones putting her purse in the car. As soon as she goes in the theater, I'm going to find a way to get into that trunk.
Correct. And also realize that you can keep your driver's license, your main credit card with you, something like that, to make payments and things like that. That's absolutely, completely acceptable. But prepping in advance and realizing that if you're having those funny feelings in your stomach or the little hairs on the back of your neck stand up, that might be that opportunity. And I always say that's your guardian angel tapping you on the shoulder saying, pay attention.
Yes.
So if you feel uncomfortable, no matter where you're at, and a lot of times there can be security in the area, you can ask them to walk you out, you can wait for a large crowd and walk out with them. You know, there's always safety in numbers.
Don't be afraid to ask.
Correct.
Even in a shopping center or a shopping mall, you can ask for a security guard to walk you to your car.
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. And also, this was brought up earlier when we were discussing, is the fact that, you know, this time of year we do have, like I said, the daylight hours are much longer, but understand that we do have intermittent weather, so that if you start to get the rain and you're putting your wipers on, you need to put your headlights on too as well. So
just
it's very
for safety.
Important. Yes, absolutely. It's very important. And understand that, you know, as the weather changes, you know, and it can change very quickly. We have very hot weather right now, but typically comes with that is thunderstorms.
Yes.
So understand that, you know, that's part of that whole process, is being a good driver, paying attention to your environment. And if you don't feel comfortable and it's starting to rain in sheets, pull off on the side of the road. You can put your hazards on, that type of thing. You know, so I want people to feel comfortable when they're out and about, and I understand weather can change.
Don't try to drive in a storm.
Correct.
And never drive through water.
Yes, absolutely. Standing water is not a good thing at all.
Better to arrive someplace a little late.
Correct.
But just pull off someplace that looks like it's not going to be underwater. Pull off someplace and wait.
Absolutely.
I have done that many times.
Yes. And like I said, those are kind of the standards of as the summertime kicks in. And like I said, from the phone scams to identity theft to credit card theft, you know, when you go grocery shopping, or let's say you're out and about, you know, zip up your purse, you know, because that's that time where someone can grab a credit card, grab a wallet,
quickly,
things like that, very much so.
And never leave your purse sitting in a shopping cart.
Correct.
Yes.
And also, a lot of times people ask me, like, oh, I want to wrap the purse around my head. I don't particularly advise that, because if someone does try to grab your purse, that means you're going to the ground.
I haven't heard that one.
Yes. And I would say this, nobody wants to struggle or fight on the ground. So, you know, you can have it on your shoulder and you can pull it to the front of you.
Yeah, I usually do like this.
Correct.
Which looks a little strange, but I don't care.
Exactly. You know, we don't care what other people's opinions are. And for the men, I would say take your wallet out of your back pocket where you don't have a lot of nerve endings and put it in your front pocket. Because if someone tries to reach into your front pocket, you should know about that.
Yes.
Whereas in your back pocket, you don't have the nerve endings in the back like you do in the front.
I'd say also when we're out shopping and we're going out in the summertime, make sure you have some water with you.
Absolutely.
Because if your car breaks down and you have no water, you're in real trouble.
Absolutely. It's always good to have, you know, a granola bar in the car, something that doesn't melt, you know, having road flares, having water, even if it's warm at this point, water is
water. And if you have a cell phone, have it charged, have it with you so you can call for help.
Absolutely. You should always have a cord in the car, you know, so that if you need to charge it, whatever it may be. But yes, having a cell phone, being prepared in advance can make your life so much easier in case of that emergency or that sudden downpour or your car breaks down or whatever it may be. You know, and a lot of people get, you know, roadside services. You know, that's fine too as well if that makes you more comfortable to go out and about in the community and drive. But that's not a have to, it's not a necessary. But again, you can call the local police department. And I always say, in your cell phone, you should have it under a non-emergency. And that's here for Fairfax County. And that's the 703-691-2131.
Let me write that down because I don't know that number.
Yes.
703-691-2131.
And it should be in your phone under a non-emergency because that will come up at the top of your contacts.
Okay. So non-emergency, if I get in trouble on the road like that, I can call.
Correct. And also, if you're seeing something suspicious, and suspicious means different things to different people.
Sure.
Depending on our experience, our background, where we were brought up. But again, those are those moments where you see a suspicious car, you see a suspicious person, you know, they have a hoodie, they're smoking a cigarette.
Something doesn't look right.
Correct. You know, a suspicious noise. You can call the non-emergency number and you can advise that you want an officer to come through the area. That's okay. That's your tax dollars hard at work. Use them to your benefit. That cruiser in and of itself is its own deterrent. And if you don't believe me, drive down Fairfax County Parkway, crest a hill, and you see a cruiser parked off in the distance. What do people do?
They slow down.
They
it works
slow
every
down.
Time.
Yes, so that cruiser is its own deterrent.
Yes.
Use it to your benefit. If you feel uncomfortable, you're not the Marines, you don't have to take the hill, you can say, hey, I'm walking out to my car. You know, there's suspicious people that are kind of hanging out by my car. You know, they don't look like they're in doing business, whatever it may be. They're cursing, they're swearing. You know, can I have a cruiser drive through the area? Do that.
Good. Good. Thank you for the advice.
You're very welcome.
We have 1 minute left. What else would you like to add?
You know, I think the biggest thing is I want everybody to be safe. That's part of the reason why I'm in crime prevention. And I think just being aware of your environment, not being paranoid, being aware of your environment, paying attention, looking around. As you walk up to your vehicle, look under the car. As you're walking up, scan the area. And then get in your car. And I always tell my daughter, close the door, lock it, turn on the car. And if you need to situate yourself then at that point, that's fine. Because if someone walks up, then you can drop it and drive and you're out of there.
And in this hot weather, we want to allow our cars a little bit of time to cool off.
Absolutely.
You know, open those windows if you can. But if you're in an area where you don't feel comfortable, get out of that area. Move to some place where you do.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Stay safe.
Absolutely.
Right. Officer Eggers, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Oh, it's always a pleasure.
And we wish you
here.
A safe summer, and thanks to all the Fairfax County Police Department for taking good care of us.
Oh, thank you guys so much.
And we hope you all will join us again soon.